Hello everyone, welcome back to Sun Innovative YouTube channel, and we are back with a new video on class C commutation of SCR or the thyristor. And in the recent part, those who have not seen the video, please do refer the class A and class B commutation. And in that video we have also discussed the important factor and the points regarding the commutation. And again I am telling you that what is a commutation, because commutation, it is a method to forcefully become the SCR turn off, and the technique we are going to discuss in this video, that is a class C. And this is the topology and the circuit diagram of class C commutation, and this is the circuit waveform as you can see here. So let us start the simulation and to understand regarding and the introduction about the class C commutation. So here you can see the load resistance is connected by this way, and one more additional resistance is connected. This is the not load resistance, this one is load resistance, and the both SCR is connected parallel with each other through the capacitor. And this is the waveform of class C commutation, and you can see here the gate pulse is given to the SCR1. Here this gate pulse is given to this SCR1, so that time the path of this circuit would be like this way. The current will be goes to this battery and this resistance, load resistance, and the SCR, because it is short circuited, and current obviously follow the less resistance path through the circuit as per the Ohm's law, and it will the negative terminal gives to the negative of battery. And during this one you can see here the two SCR are used, because one SCR, it is for the turn on, and the second SCR for the turn off. And how it is possible, that I am going to explain these things. Okay, so you can see this is the path, but one more path is also there. So you can see here the positive terminal, this current is also goes to this resistance, but at this point now the current is separated in a two way, like the it can goes to the capacitor and it also can goes to the SCR2. But when the SCR1 is turned on and the S2, the switch is also off, so your current won't be going to this direction. It compulsory has to pass this, follow the capacitor and make the attachment with the original current or the primary current like this way. So that time I can say the capacitor was in a charging condition when the SCR1 is got turned on. Okay, so as you can see here, the voltage across SCR, that would be the current across the SCR, it is turned on and it follow this path, and the capacitor voltage across SCR1, it would be like this. There is a zero voltage. And how it got commutated, it means when the gate pulse is given to the SCR2, now in a situation that the SCR is turned on, so that's why this polarity, you can see the capacitor polarity got short circuited like this way, because this is the switch and one it is get turned on. So this polarity, positive charge of the capacitor is directly goes to the cathode of the SCR, and the negative polarity charge, it directly goes to the anode of the SCR. So I can say the whatever the charge across the capacitor, it will appear directly across the SCR1. So as we know that once the negative is with the anode and the positive with the cathode, so it will be going to consider in a reverse bias. So slowly as per the charge which is appear on the capacitor, will make the anode current less than the holding current. Okay, so this way you can turn off the SCR of this class C commutation. Okay, if you don't understand the whole circuit, please repeat this video, so you will be understand the path. Okay, and please do refer this waveform for understanding this thyristor commutation. So it is I am not saying that it is not important, but I am saying that if you have the question regarding the circuit and operation, please do refer the internet sources, because many papers and many researchers have given the theory about the commutation circuit, but no one have given the simulation. You can search in a MATLAB MATLAB site, you can search in a YouTube, you can search in a Google. All have given the theory, all have given the the working and the principle of the commutation, but no one has done the simulation in a MATLAB simulation software. And those who have done, so that is a, I don't know who have done this simulation. So we are respectable for that person also, that those who are working on a commutation. So please guys, do share this video for the researcher and the student, those who are looking for the simulation of commutation. So I am here to solve the all question regarding the class C commutation. So you can see this is a MATLAB simulation circuit here, and this is a DC voltage, and as per the circuit diagram theory, as I was shown in theory, so this all components are connected in a manner of the class C commutation. And you can see the two thyristors are used here, one thyristor for the turn on and the second thyristor for the turn off. And the pulse generator, let me show you the pulse generator. So you can see I have selected the 2000 frequency and the 50 hertz on the duty cycle, and the, I have selected the load resistance as a 100 ohm. And let me show you the one more thing, that is a capacitor value here, so that is a 0.1 microfarad. And let run this simulation and showing the results. Okay, so let me open the simulation results. So here you can see the last one, sorry, mistakenly I have given the input voltage in a last the waveform, because in a recent part class A, B, I have given the input voltage in a first priority, but now I am given in a last priority because it is a constant voltage. So this is the input voltage. Please guys, do refer this last the waveform. It should be here, but I have taken the fourth one. So it is input voltage 300 voltage as I have given. And coming to the first graph, that is a gate pulse of SCR1. So, and the this dotted line of yellow, that is a gate pulse for SCR2, and this is the red line, that is the output voltage of the commutation. So now explanation of this waveform. So you can see the first thyristor have the gate pulse here. So you can see here the output voltage, it got conducting because the SCR1 will give the output voltage, and this is the output gate pulse for the thyristor 2. Let me give the name here also. I didn't give the name. Let me write gate pulse of T2 thyristor. Okay, and let me give the Y label also, magnitude VDC. Okay, so you can see here the gate pulse of thyristor T2 here. So when the pulse is removed from the T1 thyristor and the pulse is given to the T2 thyristor, let me open the circuit again. So first of all, the gate pulse is given to T1 thyristor, and that time your SCR is going to conduct it, and circuit is turned on, so voltage will be appear across the load resistance. And when the gate pulse is removed from the T1 thyristor, and the again gate pulse is given to the T2, because NOT gate is connected, so you will be get the invert output voltage, gate pulse of the SCR. So the T2 thyristor have gate pulse now. So as I told you that according to the circuit diagram, when the gate pulse is given to the T2 thyristor, your SCR T1 is going to turn off. So you can see here the current which is passing from the SCR1, or the voltage across the SCR1, so it goes turn off like this way. You can see here at this moment when we have given to the gate pulse to the T2 thyristor, your output voltage is suddenly goes zero values like this way, and this spike is appear here because of the capacitor which I have connected across these two thyristor like this way. Okay, because it got sudden discharge, so that's why at this moment, because at this moment I have the T1 thyristor turn off, and at this moment T2 is turned on, so that's why capacitor got short circuited, and the sudden voltage is appear across this way, and it got discharge like this way at this moment, and at this point is completely turn off the SCR. And again I wanted to turn on the SCR1, so again I have given the gate pulse to the T1 thyristor, so it start conducting this way, and the output voltage appear across this resistance like this way. And again if I am given the gate pulse to the T2 thyristor, so it going to turn off like this way. So these points are force commutated point. And I'm telling you that that point is depend upon the value of resistance and the capacitor which I have connected here, and also that depend upon the width and the percentage of duty cycle you have given to the SCR. That also matters here, because it also depend upon the gate pulse. So if you change the gate pulse, so the turning off point is also going to change. So let me change these things here in this simulation. So I'm going to change the width of pulse. So let me make to the 30%. So you can see the changes which is I have done here. So you can see the 30% turn on period will make the SCR conductors for the 30% only. And during the T2 thyristor turn on, your SCR will be going to turn off for this particular period, because we have given the 30 to 70% ratio. So for this period, your SCR is going to turn off because the T2 thyristor was on. So that time, again, when you give the gate pulse to the T1 thyristor, your T2 is going to turn off and will start conducting like this way. So this is all about the commutation of class C thyristor, and this is the method which is used the commutation. And the disadvantage of this commutation method, that is one more additional switch you need to use for the commutation, and the additional losses will be generated due to the switch is connected. And I think there is a no resonance problem because inductor is absent in this circuit, only the capacitor is connected. But yes, I can say the spike voltage is very high due to the capacitor, so that is going to affect it to the thyristor because of the spike voltage. And it is obviously important circuit for the all power electronic. So thank you guys, thank you very much. And if you guys have the questions and queries, please do write in a comment, and like this video and share this video for the industrial people and the researcher, those who need this simulation. Thank you guys, thank you very much.